Oh, I went a little early, but we'll be okay.
It's okay. That's what the clap's for.
That's what she said.
Welcome back.
Oh, shit. We should start again.
To difficult.
Difficult indeed.
Difficult terrain.
Yes. Welcome back to Difficult Terrain Podcast, episode 24.
Yeah.
Part one, as we're calling it.
Why are there multiple parts?
Who knows? Maybe we can talk about it on our Patreon at some point. So, if we ever get a Patreon, we would love to have you guys subscribers if you want to support all 20 of you. Appreciate it.
Wealthy 20 of people.
Yes, wealthy with entertainment. I did have a question, speaking of entertainment, you know, because everybody goes out in the summertime, and the summer is coming to a close. That's a long segue. But I was just thinking about, you know, I'm talking to people because I don't like the winter. I don't like being cold. I don't like being this far north and this far away from an ocean. I was wondering what your favorite season is. Are you more of a summer person? Do you like the winter? Or do you live in that spring and fall mid-range situation?
What do you associate being close to an ocean with being warm?
I do. I know it's not always that close, but I would not move to an ocean where it's cold, like Alaska Pass.
I mean, just like
Boston,
like any place Boston on the East Coast chilly. That isn't Florida. You go to
South Carolina, North Carolina
is not warm. Like, it's not like
it may not be.
But it's not
warm.
Freezing.
It's not freezing.
But it's not here. It's not terrible here. But
here,
you
being
know,
DC.
It just drags forever to it. And you think it's over. You're like, oh, it's March. It should warm up. No, it's just that it just clings on like muck or like mustard stain on your shirt.
You can get rid of those, you know. They don't have to stay.
Really? I just throw the shirt away.
Oh, that's fair. I respect that.
Mustard's evil, man. Yeah.
I mean,
damn Dijon.
It gets pretty cold in DC, but I don't know. I'm definitely a winter, fall kind of guy. I enjoy spring, but dread it because it means summer's coming. But I can deal with spring.
Hmm. Spring forward.
So I'm in Boston, mm-hmm. and I'm very much the same as you, Dolph, but would hate being cold. I used to always love summer and like hate fall and winter. But like this past two summers, I've basically not had AC until last year, or like a fan or anything, because I'm just like fine with it. I like, you know, I'll just get all, you know, like gross, and I'll shower in the morning and whatnot, but like I'm fine with it. The past year has been really bad. So global warming is kicking my ass in the summer, so I'm starting to not like that as much. And this fall has just been delightful. It's like dry, it's like beautiful, and I'm becoming a fan of that. And winter's okay until you hit like February, and then it's just a nightmare, which is when I go like south for vacation.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. I'm with you. Although I wish it was dry here. It's been wet for just weeks.
Yeah. That's terrible. I was down there for some of it, but I'm glad I left.
Yeah, it was a good call. It was bad. Eric, how about you, man?
I mean, Matt and I went to school in a place that snowed from, what would you say, October to April? There was snow on the ground, roughly.
Buffalo.
No, it wasn't as bad as Buffalo, but it was pretty close. So, I mean, there was a lot of winter going on. So really, really appreciate summer for what it is. That being said, DC summers are terrible. God, they're so awful. It's humid as hell. Like, I never want to be outside. So I'm a big fall and spring kind of guy, for sure. I like the hoodie weather. Like, I mean, even right now, you know, 60 degrees out, still wearing shorts and a t-shirt. I don't want to do the 90 degree weather, 100% humidity thing that it was DC summers.
Yeah.
And I don't want to do the 4 feet of snow on the ground every day for 8 months of the year thing that was upstate New York. So I'm good with fall and spring personally.
The mild, the mediocre temperatures.
Yeah.
Maybe that's the right word for that.
Yep. Mediocre.
Matt, Speaking of mediocre, Matt, what do you?
You know, like, not to get all miscongeniality about you describe your perfect date, and you know, but I would say, like, you know, October 8th, October 9th, October 12th, like that kind of range, like early fall, crisp, not too hot, not too cold. All you need is a light jacket, so to speak. But I have been going in the recent years for allergy shots. I had really bad seasonal allergies for ragweed pollen and stuff. So I used to like hate the spring. And now I am completely, I don't want to say, you know, knock on wood, cured, but like seasonal allergies don't affect me as badly as they did. So I actually enjoy the spring a lot now, more than I used to as a teenager in my 20s. And so if I'm metagaming here, I'm going to pick the spring because the spring gives me the chance to also access the summer and fall immediately after it.
Mm. So, okay.
Yeah. So just, you know, push winter off further and further and further, because fall's amazing, but then you do eventually segue into winter. So let me live spring and then run through summer and fall.
Sure. I'm with you. Fall is like the Sunday of the seasons. You know, you're like, oh, I'm having a good time, I'm relaxing, but I gotta work tomorrow.
Sunday scaries, yeah.
But so I
mean, that's when all the holidays happen. Like you have all of the holidays happening in the fall. There aren't that many holidays.
I.e., that's when you're spending all your money on plane tickets.
That's when you get all the days off.
Yeah, true.
That is cool too. Yeah, I think that. I was more thinking weather, but it is nice to get the days off for good. I didn't know we still celebrated Indigenous Day, we call it now, right? Did they take Columbus off altogether?
It depends, but it's still like a bank holiday, but like not really like as much of like a corporate holiday, I think, anymore.
It's a federal government holiday. Because I drove
the USPS and it was closed.
Yeah, it's a federal holiday still. But like...
Okay, just not Columbus anymore. No. Which is good. He was a real... He was a dick. So, And he didn't even discover America. So it's just like, what are we celebrating this for?
I mean,
that's a whole other story. Another story for another day. It was a different time. The Golden Age.
Is that Golden Age?
I don't think
it's the Gilded Age.
That's
maybe?
The Boomer's Age.
We've wrapped gold around the decaying, decrepit metal underneath.
Back when America was great.
Oh, is that what it was? was America around?
Columbus discovered it. Come on, guys.
It wasn't called America until the map got back there and the guy made the map.
Before we ruined it all.
No, yeah. Well, you know, that's just making me sad. So, moving on. It is now fall and we are going to winter in these caverns.
Winter's coming?
Hopefully no one takes a fall in these caverns.
We'll find out.
That's right.
All right.
Japan. So last time, the last time you guys played this game.
A whole week ago.
A long time ago.
Whole week ago.
Yes. Yeah. I think I'm wearing the same shirt. So long. But
it's my favorite shirt.
You guys got into a fight with a fly and a mean evil enforcer gremlin that for a moment I thought might be a problem for you guys, but you guys just stepped on
just
them both.
Like a moment?
That was it. That was it. The fly went down, and then Herbal went down.
I can't believe this guy was sent to kill us. Like, who thought this guy was going to kill us?
When you were sleeping, perhaps? I don't know.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Mm. Maybe.
But no problems. You guys are good. You're still in the middle of these caverns. You are, I mean, kind of look at what you've mapped here and got a good section of this place out, it seems like. I mean, who knows how deep it goes or which direction, but you guys are doing good.
Yeah.
Making good time, as my dad would say, on the road.
That's what he would say. Okay.
That is a very dad thing.
Yeah, every time?
It's true. Yeah.
Yeah. Ever since 3 months ago, I say that now.
Leaning into that dad role.
Yeah, yeah. Went down to North Carolina, making good time.
Nice. O2 moves over to the rotten carcasses of meat and takes a little bathroom break.
No! Don't pee on the meat.
Maybe Benji wants something
that's
to eat.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, really?
Well, I mean, as you search this creature.
I pee on the dead body of that dude, though.
Oh, the gremlin. Zoe's going to heal himself while all this is going on.
Okay.
Klaus will definitely regain his focus point by meditating.
Yeah, and Gory will explore what's in that creature's stomach.
Whatever. Can I increase my hit points? I'm going to max out because I have been spindling.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You spindle.
I'm going to go back to my max HP.
I think that's fair.
Gordy's going to see what's on this guy's body, on Herbal's body. Sound like had some cool
pets. Pat around this.
I'm gonna check what's on the fly's body, just so you know.
Okay, yeah, you reach in. Spiders! Hands covered with spiders. No, it's disgusting goo. And Gordy reaches out down and like it kind of wipes off the Corsican's pee and pulls. He has a pouch.
What is in the pouch?
You open the pouch, a plain pouch, it seems like. It has 4 gold teeth. GT, we call them. So you get 4 GT, 1 each if you split it up.
Okay.
And they're worth 3 gold pieces each. So
weird.
Really, yeah.
We got grills?
Being was the were these one teeth grill. Formed for? Oh, okay. Like, are these like human teeth? Or like...
Yeah, you can roll a nature check for me.
Yeah, Gordy, I'm super skilled in nature.
What does Corsican really know about human teeth?
You Gordy rolled a natural one. So
I guess half human. You're pretty sure it's a dragon's teeth.
I also rolled a natural one.
You are also convinced. You're for sure. Both of you get together and you're like, dragon's teeth.
Dude, I think there's a dragon underneath the tunnels.
Little ones, be careful. Dragons. There be dragons.
If you both think there are dragons, there's clearly dragons down here. We must move forward with the utmost care.
Well, before you do, you notice that bloody pick that Otoa, you notice it on the ground, and it has a +1 rune in it. +1 and striking rune.
Oh.
Oh, boy. That's huge. All right, roll off.
Oh, that is very huge.
Who doesn't have a +1 rune?
We all do. I think we all now. Have +1. I mean,
I bought my own.
I don't think Otoa does, but Otoa doesn't need one because he's, you know.
Yeah.
Mm. He's one of them.
For his fist.
I'm a back boy.
He's a back boy.
And a striking.
No one has a striking.
Everybody
has a
striking.
Yeah.
Well,
no one.
Didn't Lorna buy one? Didn't Corsican buy one with all his money before we started? Or was that a +2?
No. Corsican bought the +1.
What was that called?
Oh, no, you did buy the striking. Corsican has a striking.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh, yeah. Shit. I thought so.
That's why you did 22 damage. I remember
being convinced into doing it.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry.
Yeah. What is it called? I don't know.
It's called striking rune. So if you look at your the name of your...
So it's +1 striking rapier.
Yeah, you see +1 striking rapier. It means you double your damage dice. So instead of...
Got it.
1d6 plus 2, you do 2d6 plus 2. Oh, okay. So it's a roll-off between Josh and myself. Yeah.
That's nice.
Between who gets this, right?
Do you want to do this through Foundry? So that way you can't cheat.
Oh, dang. Wow. Calling out cheaters
called
already.
Called out. I've never cheated in my life at this game.
You guys can spend your hero points on this roll if you guys want.
Oh, Monopoly's a time to cheat.
This game, no.
It's in the name.
All right. It kind of is. All right. I will roll 1d20 in Foundry.
Mm. Oh, shit.
Ooh.
Damn.
Oh, we both did through Corsican.
Why did we do that?
Who is who? I don't know.
Mine says Josh underneath Corsican.
It sure does. Yeah. Nice. Damn, you rolled an 18 and I got a 1.
Yes.
Corsican said, I'll make this fair. I'll roll for both of you.
And we know I like Josh more.
Yeah.
Whatever his name is, Klaus.
You like Josh more. Yes. Now, I take that personally. If you said you like Klaus more, fine.
Well, look, it's not the same since you became a dad.
I guess.
To be fair, is Gordy really going to use a pickaxe?
Well, no. I
assume you leave the pickaxe.
Yeah, the axe
can move from the
gems.
You take the rune and put it on your weapon.
Yeah, it does take time. Though,
it takes a day, but yeah. And so we're not going to do it right now.
So I can't immediately put it over.
Yeah, and we could sell that +1.
What we should do. Shall we continue on? How is your self-healing?
Oh yeah, I got to roll my. I'm glad. Actually, I'm glad that one went to the healing and not to
The med check.
Or I'm sorry, I'm glad it went to the pick, not the healing.
Can I throw my spindle on top of him for a hot sec?
Then I just healed 11.
Oh yeah, but you can't do that, of course. It's like attuned to you.
Yeah. That's. I'm very okay with that.
Thanks.
I would love to share with
you. A little too okay?
All right, so after 20 minutes, I'm back to almost full. I just healed myself for another 11, so.
All right, which way are you guys going? Who's leading? What do you want to do?
We're going to the northwest or the...
There's a lot of caverns.
Or northeast or southeast?
Well, maybe we take Benji's counsel, assuming Benji doesn't mind offering some information about what is those directions.
Yes.
In exchange for some warm, spoiled meat, which he likes.
It's not spoiled yet. It was just killed.
Yeah, sometimes I sneak in here and eat some of the flies' food. Says, there's some more beds up north and more tunnels. That's mostly what's up there. I think they're digging. I don't know. I'm not really supposed to go down there, but I've been down there.
Then we should definitely go down there.
There's some art drawings on the hanging on the wall. Mm-hmm. It's really scary.
I could take in an exhibit or two.
I do love a free gallery.
Yeah.
Sell some of the gremlin work for profit at the market.
Made by real gremlins.
Shall we?
Let's go.
Great.
Unless you guys feel compelled to go elsewhere.
No, it's fine. I just...
Beep!
That sound, for those listening, is Corsican just jumping across the map.
Did you?
That's the sound Corsican makes.
Corsican is full-on Leroy Jenkinson.
Did someone...
You made it.
Someone trapped me somehow. Wait, now which way do we want to go? Do we want to go... to the south?
Let other people catch up on the map first.
Ooh. Never.
So that's why Otua isn't all the way in the back.
This is a very good move.
As you go down there, you do see stuff on the wall, but in that little gap in the very south of where you are. My X is not working yet. Down there, it looks like something hanging on the wall.
Okay, I'll wait for when I catch up before I go investigate.
Otua went the long way around.
I'm sure I'm trained in art.
Well, being trained an artist, that's a great skill to have.
Yeah.
Please tell me about the artistry we find.
Yes. I don't know what to start because I don't have I'm supposed to get this information from Dolph, but I can totally BS it.
Did you want to go down to it?
Is it down here?
Yeah. Oh,
am I
this
in a
is
wall?
So pretty.
Yes, I think the it's a blood on canvas of of rock.
That's good. No, actually, there's three cloaks and three masks that look.
I totally pick one up and put on my face.
They do look old. They look like masks that are carved at the ceremony that you went to recently.
Yeah, detect magic.
They look like old masks that were carved.
The arms of the cloaks are extended to the side. And everything's colorful, but dirty and blood-stained. And one of the masks depicts a stern antelope, another a kindly hare, and the last a smiling warthog. You detect magic. You do detect magic here.
Can I do perception rolls?
Yes, absolutely. Let me roll for you here.
Or like an arcana?
Yep. You notice the mask with the hare on it, the mask of a hare. The way it's cocked, it seems to be leaning on, depressing some sort of button, which is leaving, and you look up and there's like a slight crease where maybe a door is slightly open. You think it's a secret door, and it's made just a little bit differently than the other ones.
I communicate that and very slowly go to push it and see if my teammates will stop me.
Five would stop you at this point.
Y'all
it's been
ready for 20, this?
23 episodes of not being able to stop Corsican.
And ahead, you see a long hallway, which then veers. Well, I guess you'll find out. To the right,
start
left.
I start cartwheeling down it stealthily.
I do some tumble. Benji, you ever been down this hall? Benji, you know this hall was here. Benji.
Oh, Benji. Oh, she's behind. She's, no, I've never been in here.
Oh. All right. Well, friends, we might want to be a little careful if our new friend here has not explored these caverns. Oh. This might be where the
Corsicon was stealthing.
Yeah, I'm stealthing.
Okay. I mean, that's fine. Just saying.
Can we all approach stealthily?
No.
Klaus would also stealth this Corsicon.
But stealth skipping, oh. Right?
Stealth skipping, yes.
Sorry. Is
that also subtle art of stealth skipping?
Come on, guys.
All right. Yeah, I mean, Gordy and Zoe will step up.
All right. And Otua, you good there?
Otua kind of gets into the door frame and draws a potion.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
Not to consume, just, carrying around in my hand.
At the ready.
Yeah.
Did you all want to roll our stuff?
This is an unopened potion.
I rolled. Well, I rolled Corsicon's in first, in front. I figured that'd be good enough for us for how far she is away from things.
Key, but yeah.
Yes. The player Corsicon.
Perfect.
Yeah. You see what you see, Corsi. You see veers off to the right and to the left. Who's going to move? Who's making a move? What's happening? You guys scoot up behind her?
So Klaus will whisper to Corsicon, what way would you like to go? To the left or to the right? It looks like it's a T-junction ahead of us. Oh. Or just straight ahead. I appreciate that.
No word.
Tactic.
No word. Your audio is muted.
Yeah. To your left?
That's a problem, Lorna.
Oh.
You heard the Beyonce part, though?
No.
No.
No. Oh,
we missed someone else say that? Like
great jokes
minutes.
Over here. Nobody's laughing. I thought you were really stealthing.
Yeah.
No. Let's check out the room on the right. It looks like a small bedroom and nothing else, but let's just double check.
Yes, let us go.
Go in there. Very similar setup. Maybe a little bit nicer.
Oh, another tunnel.
But it looks like gremlin gunk here, and you find three. Well, I guess we'll make it four. So this is four. Your four gold pieces worth of junk stuff you could put together and sell.
Nice.
You pull the copper out of the wiring for the lamp.
If you look
north, there's another long hallway. It looks like it runs parallel to the other one. It just goes to a wall.
So silly.
And the other side of the hall that turned to the left is also a dead end.
Does it help to... Wait, to the left is also a dead end?
Yep. You see
That's
exactly
stupid.
What you
we
see.
We should investigate for buttons.
Yes, it is unlikely there are so many dead ends in the caverns full of secret doors. The little one and I
check?
Will check the door to the
Okay,
to the west.
Klaus, you want to come out with me north side?
Both you and Gordon.
I would recommend not going too far.
I suppose we could just wait for them to see what's going on over
there. I'll take a meditation break. There's something to perceive. That's a good sign.
I will tell you, there's no more, you don't detect magic anymore if you're still detecting magic. You pass whatever it was.
Oh.
Mm.
I know it kind of got looked over, so I just wanted to bring it up.
Oh, well, thank you.
Not a big deal.
It is a big deal. That's loot.
I am back. Sorry about the brief wait for our sponsors. great. So
thanks, Google.
So yeah, you do detect a secret door in this wall. Looks like a similarly crafted as the one you just went through up north.
Gordy will open it, and he'll call back.
Little ones, I have found the door to the west. I will open it right now.
Shall we?
Well, I'd hate to go not through a door, so let's do it.
Swords out. Battle. Equipment out, everybody.
Come up everybody where they want to be.
Absolutely, Corsica.
All right. Door opens.
Wow.
Ooh.
Well, we found our new room.
Sounds
a party
like the
room.
Captain's headquarters.
You might call this a well-appointed bedroom and study. Almost makes one forget that is hidden deep underground. This space is neatly furnished with mismatched items, including a bearskin rug and an extraordinarily comfortable looking chair. A heavy professor's desk.
What? My lady friend likes to read in a chair that was comfortable.
Isla.
I told you. I need that
point.
I need it. Give it to me.
I mean, just because there's a chair in a room does not mean that we've solved the mystery.
You're the one that jumps to the conclusions about Isla.
Well, you know what? I'm pulling back.
Because it means you get a hero point. I'm pulling back.
Yeah. We're on the same team.
A heavy professor's desk from the school sits off to one side, along with a massive, gently scuffed four-poster bed. So it's a studio, basically. He can't afford
notebooks.
a one bedroom in DC, so they're expensive. Rugs and curtains hang in an inadequate attempt to make the space seem less like a cave, but a craggy wall peeks through the gaps.
Craggy wall.
C-R-A-G-G-Y.
Craggy.
You know? That's a good word. But yes, to answer your question, Corazon, there are books on the desk. There are some, there's no, not like a library of books, but there are some books around here and scrolls and stuff on the, in various areas.
Okay. No one's moving, so.
I mean, you gotta let the flavor text be read. And then you know.
These are how things work.
There's a system. Corazon.
It and is. We follow it. It just takes a while because you, with your eyes, you can see it all at once and take it in.
Oh, that's fair.
As Corazon goes in, Klaus will follow. So you said there was a desk across the way with books on it, correct?
The desk is.
I want to inspect the bed to see who sleeps in it. If it's like an elf or human, what type of hair I'm looking at. Perception checks, mi amigo.
Okay. So. Okay, yeah, Corazon, you are checking out the bed. Klaus, you're looking at the desk over there. And Corazon, you hear something under the bed.
Oh.
I look under the bed.
You point under the bed, and there are two gremlins under there playing with something. And we are going to roll into initiative.
Oh, of course. Of course.
I will.
Of
course. I do need to remove.
Are they like baby gremlins or something? Why are they under the bed?
Is this.
They're tiny, so.
Babies would not attack us.
Okay, gotcha. We're going into initiative. Let me put everybody in.
Yeah, only if you feel like you need to. I mean,
bad roll.
No rush, no bad hurry. Roll. Oh, Phil Klaus isn't going fast.
I got a 21.
All right. Way to brag.
Well,
17 for Tua.
Oh, Tua? 17? You already had one in here? 17. Great. Klaus?
Klaus got an 8.
8.
For those
thank you.
And German speakers out there.
Zoe, how did you do?
Zoe a little bit better. Got a 17.
Also a 17. All right. So up first, Josh, as you are peeking and you're looking at this desk, there are a lot of notes here, fresh notes. And you're kind of looking and you look at the wall. There's like a tapestry. And through the tapestry...
Tapestry.
I always say tapestry. I think it's the E that gets me, but I like that better. So through the tapestry, you're like, oh, it's a very weird design, but something's really weird on this tapestry. And you kind of lean in.
I would only lean into a tapestry, but go on.
Yes. Well, I'm going to lean in on this tapestry pronunciation.
Mm-hmm. And so, I respect that. And you would do the same.
What you see is an ear coming through this tapestry. And then a hand comes out and a body comes out. It is your turn, King.
So a young looking man, apparently made of stone and oddly wearing armor, despite being made of stone,
you got to
steps
wear clothes.
Silently from the wall and swings a morning star.
Oh.
Because that's not going to feel good.
That's a 23.
Is that for the hit?
That will hit.
Roll your damage.
9 damage.
That still's not feeling great, but I'll take it.
Not bad. And
as he like smacks you, he just kind of looks down his nose and goes, "Really?"
Well, what did you expect? I was looking at books.
And he seems a little bit slower when he first came out of the wall, so he only gets 2 actions. Corazon, you're up.
That's good to know. Can I do like perception check on what this thing is more or less immune to?
Like a knowledge check?
Yep. It's going to be a nature check. You think it would be nature. Did you? Okay, go ahead.
Do I have to do it?
Yeah, I'll let you do it.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to let you roll it. How about that? Yeah, you're right.
7.
It is me. Yeah, maybe I should have rolled it after all. So, yeah, you're not sure what this thing is. You're definitely sure it's a gremlin.
The ghost is? The stone ghost?
Oh, you're looking at the ghost. I apologize. The ghost is a society check. I will roll it for you. How about that?
Okay. Society about +1.
Oh, +1? Yeah,
you don't untrained, know. Though.
Yeah, you're untrained. Yeah.
That's why. So, yeah. Either way, you didn't know what either one was. I gave you 2 checks for free. And cool. Extra check for free. So great. You have two actions left. This thing is under the bed and officially prone.
I'm going to leave those guys. I want to see if I can push that stone ghost back through the wall.
Okay.
I don't know. I feel like that might do something.
I dig it. You got to move up and shove it?
I'm going to move up to here. Can I reach from there?
Yep, for sure.
Is it just like an unarmed strike?
It is a shove. You can use whatever body part you want. Kick or push doesn't matter, but it's going to be the same push. Check. It's going to be a, I believe, athletics check.
Yeah, it's athletics.
Oh, okay. Athletics I can do.
So if you roll a d20, add your athletics bonus.
14 total.
14 total. Yeah, that is... Ooh. No, I will definitely won't do it. Okay. Unfortunately. Pushes, and your hand goes a little bit through him. Like, it's not, he's not completely there, it seems like.
So he's like... He's kind of like, okay. So it's like ghostly. Butter, like ketchup viscosity here. Or?
Yeah, a little bit more wispy though, like a ghost. So he's got that. He's got a ghostly jam about him, if you will. But he's also physical. So he's somewhere between.
Okay. Well, sword strike then.
Sword strike it is.
So you get a mind. Well,
actually, natural 18.
That's enough actions.
Knowledge check, move, attack.
Knowledge, move, and attack. Or yep. Shove. Yeah.
Oh.
So that is wraps your turn.
God, Eric's.
Always a Debbie Downer you are.
All right. One of the little goblins stands up, moves, and takes out a short sword and moves up behind Korzakhan.
Hit me.
And says, no, don't attack my master. And... That's what he does. The other one stands up and goes over to Otua, takes out his little short sword, and says, "You!" And Otua, it's your turn.
Hold on, should we just interview them real quick to make sure they're acting on their own will here?
Oh, boy.
You don't it's have to do question. Anything you don't want to.
Korzakhan, the Sailor of Good.
Otua takes a step back, kind of close enough to be next to Zo.
That is a big step.
That is a stride.
Yeah, a stride. a long nope out of that situation. And then telekinetic projectiles, half of the bear rug. I'm not sure if I can kind of mobilize the whole kind of force
get
of it.
The but paw.
Yeah, the kind of, you know, thick, heavy paws, and try to like fold it over on top of the gremlin there to deal a little bit of slashing damage. And maybe entangle him.
I like that. And that, so as you're moving, just like pulling back with you to do a slap on the paw, maybe?
Yeah. Try to like roll him up like a, you know, you would roll up a body in a carpet.
Oh. Or tortilla.
Yeah.
Which is more tortilla.
More delicious. Unless you're Dahmer, okay. I guess.
But, a little gremlin burrito.
That
roll attack roll, bruh.
That is a 17.
That's a hit.
Nice.
Ooh.
11.
Oh, 11 damage, damn. You smushes him with this bear claw. He's so tiny, he's like, oh, smushed and broke a few bones, not looking good.
And then I moved, so that's done for me.
And he says, I'll come after you, the gremlin folk will take you down. And Zoe, you're up.
Do I want to go after the ghosts, or try to just get rid of these ads? Are these?
Well, if you take care of the little Jinkin, they'll not be flanking.
Yeah.
Nobody likes ads.
Nobody likes ads.
What did you say? They won't be whatting?
Flanking.
Flanking.
Gotcha.
What did it sound like I said?
Flanking.
Flanking. Ah. They're working out.
Oh, uh-oh. Flanking. Well,
while they're obviously. Flanking you, they're also working on their ribs.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
All right, so
they always engage the core.
So here's what's gonna happen. Gordy is going to stride 25 feet up to the north west to kind of get next to the bed to get within range, potentially striking the ghost next turn. And while Gordy does that, Zoe is gonna stride up to just south of the bed here. And get within range of 30 feet of both of these Jinkins.
Oh.
And is going to cast electric arc on both of them. So
nasty.
That is one, and then two, three. Yep. So please roll reflex saves. That is a save, yeah, 28. Not a crit save.
Oh, I'm not rolling in real life for some reason.
It's okay.
13's a fail.
Easy enough. Yeah, 13 is a fail. So 7 points of damage to the one that failed, and then 3 to the one that succeeded.
Good turn, solid turn, solid turn. Klaus, what you got going on?
So Klaus, who was looking at books with Sword Out, as we've already discussed, you know, perusing, minding his own business, all of a sudden this ghost comes out of the wall and then scoffs at a sucker punch. Like, how dare you not be prepared for my sucker punch? So Klaus immediately infuses his blade and guides his blade with True Strike and Shocking Grasp for a probably what's going to hopefully do significant damage.
Is this a triple move?
Yeah. So, casting True Strike, which for 5e fans gives me advantage, and then infusing my blade with electricity. So you just see like this electric storm go up like his arms and then surge into his sword as he goes to strike at this stone. Hopefully you're a Pokemon and electricity, or maybe not like a Pokemon. I don't remember the weaknesses for those things.
What's happening?
All right. Okay, so I was really also kind of crit fishing, but I didn't get a crit. That'll be a 28 to hit.
Ooh, that's a hit.
Not a crit? Damn it.
Not a crit. This is the stone ghost, after all.
Yeah, fair.
Stone ghost.
Oh, man. Oh, it hurts so bad. That's 9 damage.
Okay, and I'm going to need you to break that damage up for me, please.
Yeah, so 6 of it is electric.
Okay.
And 3 of it is piercing.
Okay. You feel like you do a tiny bit of damage to it.
That hurts so bad. I've been waiting for that combo.
Yeah, we don't have
any. I think we need Otua to do some Verizon Blue Cross Blue Shield.
We need a Ghost Touch rune. We don't have that.
Yeah.
Stone Coast. I'm sorry. It's my bad. My bad.
Ghost turn. He is going to reach out with his free hand, kind of clap you on the shoulder, almost as if, you know, in a friendly greeting, and just shove you downwards.
Okay.
And if he succeeds at this, it's going to be really great.
Okay. I feel like anything that you do that you succeed at will be great for you, but not for me.
Probably. I mean, that's how these things tend to. All right, so that's an athletics. Yeah.
Fortitude is my strongest.
It's going to be a 32. Well, it doesn't matter. That's actually a 20. Success. That's really bad, actually.
So 32. Oh,
that sounds right.
Is that crit?
So
it's a natural 20. That is a crit.
Yeah. Oh.
Natural 20, also a crit.
Yep.
So it's just a crit.
When Foundry is going to like happens. That means
okay,
it's a crit.
So he's going to grab you on the by the shoulder and just start pushing down, and you're just going to suddenly feel stone and soil slipping past you, almost as if jumping into a pool. And he's going to shove you all the way down into the ground, covering your head. You are completely submerged in the floor.
So like the last words of Klaus as he's pushed into the ground are like, what's the fuck?
What's the fuck? Suddenly cut off as you slip beneath the floor.
Fucked.
So that was a 2-action move. Sorry, go ahead.
And those, if all the people get buried, the guy that can turn himself into mist and pop back up.
It's pretty perfect.
That's true, actually. I was worried, but I appreciate that reminder.
So actually, it would have worked out better for me without the critical success, but it's still pretty cool. So he's going to like shove you all the way into the ground, and then he will make an attack against Kurskin with the morning star.
It's Korsakon.
Korsakon. Korsakon.
You're going to attack me. At least say my name right.
Of course. It's just good form. All right. So would Entombing Grasp count as an attack?
Is
there a map on this?
Yeah.
Okay. Does it say attack?
The shove. Yeah, yes. Shove is a attack.
So that would be a 15 on that attack.
Mm-mm.
Korsakon, that's a miss.
All right.
No. Interesting turn. Korsakon, Klaus is gone. You may see him on the map here, but actually you don't see him on the map. He just went to the ground. You see nothing of Klaus.
Yeah.
Does Korsakon know who this ghost is?
Oh. I was thinking if I could might be worth doing another perception check to see if it's like me.
I think Korzakon especially knows who this ghost may be.
I think that's what I'm saying. I think it was the me or like, you know, the images that I saw.
Woodruff.
Korzakon, you do not know. You look at this ghost, you have no idea.
Oh, damn.
It looks like a kid almost.
Damn. A kid?
Sorry. Thought I was getting my hero point.
You're not getting a hero point.
Yes.
Schadenfreude.
So I don't necessarily know where Klaus is. All I know is that he was pushed underground, but he may not actually still be there. But I mean,
you're flanked. Whatever's going on, you don't want to be where you are.
Yeah. But at the same time, do we need to save? I'm gonna is this an action? I'm just gonna be like, yo, do we need to save we need to start digging? Like, where the hell is Klaus? Or do you think he'll be able to hold his breath long enough to zap out of it?
The little one can teleport.
Alright. I'm just gonna tumble through to the other side of this.
Grim.
Thank you, Gremlin. 18.
18 hits.
Okay, and then I'm gonna use
Was this a confident finisher?
This will be a confident finisher hit. Okay. The tumble through was successful, so I've been...
18 was the... Was that the acrobatics check?
That was the acrobatics check.
Dolph was always about jumping the gun a little bit. Is that beat its reflex save?
Oh, I did do that again. let me double check. Sorry. You know what? It's tiny, so it can't stop you anyway. So roll through, no problem.
Cool. So to hit with a confident finisher, I have a 16.
Now that, on the other hand, is a miss.
Okay, that's fine.
But you do have damage on your precision, or on your confident finisher damage, rather.
Or 6 divided by 2, so 3.
3 damage. Still not bad. These things are quite an annoyance, it looks like. In fact, this one is looks slightly different. It's even though it looks the same in the picture. A little bit lighter of skin instead of that dark blue. It's more of a brown. Mm. And she says... Why you do that? Why you do that? She takes her sword and she swings at you.
Oh, I can say, I'm sorry. I was threatened, but we can be friends.
You die now. And she rolls her new die. Ooh, that's pretty good. 21 to hit.
I wasn't ready. No, yeah, that hits.
Oh, my goodness. Her damage is 1d6 minus 2.
Oh, boy.
4 damage, max damage.
Oh, wow. No.
You know what? She will she'll take another attack. Why not? For a miss. And then she will...
Was it a crit miss?
It was.
Oh, yeah. I get to respond. Sorry, I said that loudly.
That's okay. You're allowed to be excited.
I've been waiting for this for so long.
Yeah. Hold on.
So I get to strike when...
Yeah.
Take a shot. What? She's have at me.
Oh, you're such a team player. I love it.
Oh, eat your ankles.
I bet you they taste delicious. I got a 24.
That's a hit.
Excellent. 7.
Do you gain panache from this?
7 damage. Still standing, barely.
I'm happy about that, though.
She moves down to Gordy.
I go to give her a high five.
she dodges and leaves. Bye. The other one's so mad about this rug, she looks a little shaken, but she comes down after you, Otua. Takes a little tiny little short sword out and pokes you with a little needle. 23 to hit.
That hits.
Ooh. It's real damage. Oh, 4 damage again. Max damage. Well, at least they're doing something. Second attack.
Rip my tunic.
It's a critical miss. And Otua, in fact, it is your turn. This one just keeps following you around, trying to stab you.
I think Otua steps. These guys aren't really hitting too hard, so... Otua channels the Horizon Blue Cross Blue Shield.
Oh, boy.
Thunderdome, and channels it in the direction of the stone, ghastly... Dare I say daddy coming through the wall there. Well, he is a...
Yes.
Get it.
Daddy vibes.
He's got some thighs, that's for sure. Yeah.
Yeah, he's a thick boy.
I'm glad someone said it other than me. I mean, the way his like skirt is shaped, it looks like he's wearing like a little bikini bottom or something, yeah. But it's just like, it's like a skirt with a slit, but it's up the front and it's giving him like a little,
yep,
like
little speedo sort of
speedo look.
Yeah. Does he have an imprint there?
Yeah.
Oh, captain, my captain here. Let's go. So we're doing electric arc, which is I'm doing the 3-turn variety of it, 60 foot range, and if I fail, I still deal half damage.
Nice.
Potentially.
So you're casting Horizon Blue Cross.
Yes. Otua channels the energy and everyone kind of in the party is like, Otua, wait. It's like, no, it's not.
Everyone cowers in fear.
It's not the 2-turn variety. It's just the directly targeted one that hits him and doesn't explode and deal, collateral damage to everyone.
So who are you attacking? The ghost or the...
I'm dodging, the little guys that are just ripping my tunic and not really doing much else.
Stone Daddy that's
going targeted. Just Stone Daddy.
Stone Daddy. I'm going to change his name.
That's totally what he's going by.
Roll an attack roll.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. There's going to be some cover.
Oh, that's a natural 20.
Nice.
Oh, hell yeah.
Cover don't matter. That's a crit hit, boy. What's a crit do on that spell? Is it just double damage or?
3d6 doubles the damage and dazzled for one round.
Oh, that's nasty.
Okay.
Nice.
3d6 doubled. Okay.
Can he be dazzled?
7, but 14.
14 and then doubled?
It was 7.
And what type of damage is that?
Yeah, electric.
All electric. Okay. 14, you said,
electric.
Right?
Electric.
Yeah.
You dazzle him.
He dazzles me.
Yeah, you're the one who's dazzled.
Are you gonna apologize? Sorry.
Zoe, you are up.
Alright, so Zoe and Gordy are gonna try to recall knowledge at the same exact time. To try to figure out what Stone Daddy is up to. So Zoe is a plus, you said nature, I think, earlier.
Stone Daddy is gonna be society.
Oh, never mind, I don't do this. Change my mind. Otua is the only one who I think is trained in society. All right, so Gordy, so Zoe will empower Gordy as Gordy lashes out at Stone Daddy and attempts to hit from his reach.
Okay.
That is...
Roll away.
It's kind of a cracked die. It was a 15, but I'm going to do another cracked die. I need a better surface. That's a natural 6. That's a miss. 16? I'm assuming a 16 misses.
16 is a miss.
Yeah. All right. And then Zoe is going to channel his electricity again to these two gremlins. So please reflex save on the gremlins.
We're going to reflex save them up. Okay. So the one up top is 15. And the one to your right is 26.
Okay. Save it and a fail. So that is
all right.
9 points of damage. So 9 to the one that failed and 4 to the one that did not.
Oh, you almost killed
my
both.
Friend.
One goes down, though. The one on the left that was flanking
nice.
Klaus. Well, if Klaus was there.
Yeah. Yeah, we can't even see Klaus.
Is that your turn?
That is the end of my turn.
All right, Klaus. So you open your eyes and you are in like stone and ground and dirt. And you are holding your breath at this point, mechanically speaking. Mm-hmm. So the only thing you have option for here is an escape check, which is...
That's the only option.
The only option. Oh, well, obviously you have a focus point situation. So yeah.
What
I will let you do you.
What are your conditions right now?
Oh.
What are they?
You may not be able to say, yeah. Is it verbal?
Yeah, it's a verbal.
I can't target my token, so.
Yeah, what are the conditions on?
Oh, but I can go to my effects. Yeah, so I'm immobilized and flat-footed.
Yes, and then I'm not sure.
And I don't see a reason why teleportation would not be allowed.
Well, is it a gesture-based or verbal? Or what's...
So it is verbal.
Okay. So I will give you, I think you can do it, but there's going to be a flat check because as you open your mouth, dirt just compacts into your mouth. So I'm going to give you a DC 5 flat check if you want to do that.
You know, I didn't use a hero point at all last episode. I will go ahead and use it now to, oh wait, no, I can use it can, before I,
yeah.
Well, you it's can a roll flat first. Check. Okay.
Oh, but all you'll right. know, you're right. You will know the, no, I'll give you, you can use it. That's fine. It's not like there's okay. a bonus.
So I'll go ahead, roll, and then let you know if I need to use a hero point. Oh, no, we're good. So 12 on the die.
12 on the die. All right. Yeah, you poof so, out of there.
So Klaus, like moment of terror. Oh, like
second question. Do you need to see where you're going to?
No, it says I get to tumble through space. So this is kind of like Klaus's version of Korsakon's movement. So, he's a magus swashbuckler.
Tumble aren't through. They all?
They are. And you're welcome.
They really are.
Is it to target square or what is the verb? What's it called?
Teleport with any square in range with that's within reach of a creature and then make a melee strike against one creature within your reach. What's it does not specify. It's called Dimensional Assault. I can put it in chat for y'all.
But how can you target a square to go to if you don't know where it is?
Or doesn't can't see it? Mention. Targeting.
Yeah, I mean, normally but also, you need a line of effect to where you're going.
Okay.
Almost so this, always, but yeah.
So, although very cool, I don't think without being able to see where you're going, you would be able to do this.
Well, I mean, you could dimension door through a wall, right? You just have the issue of not knowing what's on the other side, potentially, right?
It depends. I mean,
same issue.
Dimension Door is a fourth level spell.
Because you can range, go up to 1 mile see. With Dimension Door, so.
No, well.
Oh, yeah.
No, it's,
well, when it's.
As long as you've been there in the
but
past.
That's a fifth level spell.
So here's one, how I'm going to roll it.
It's a little different.
Here's, you passed the DC 5 check. I'm going to. I think you can kind of guess where you are because you kind of went underground, but you don't know how far underground you are. So I'll let you go where you want, and then we will roll a dimensional die to see where you. If you land within a certain range.
Okay. All right. Sweet.
2, 3.
Sounds great. I love chance. 7, 8. Games of chance.
9.
That's why I love role-playing games and rolling well all the time. So yeah, my ideal location is
which here. Could also be inside of a wall, by the way. So
fair.
So make sure that was where you're gonna try to end up being. So okay. All right. Cool. So we're gonna roll. Okay, it's a 1d16, I rolled a 20, so I'm just gonna re-roll to make sure. Okay, you did quite well, but you ended up actually where you were, so I gotcha. So you actually ended up right there.
Okay, I guess it really doesn't matter because the thing that
has moved. Started. Okay, that was a long time to explain, but we got it.
Sweet.
What you got? Okay.
So now I get to make an attack. Against this guy.
Against Stone Daddy.
The Stone Daddy.
I love that term.
Which is gonna...
Thank you for that.
So 22 will hit, but I just realized I'm probably not gonna deal much damage.
How do you know 22 is gonna hit? That's awfully confident of you.
Oh, does 22 hit?
Yes.
All right, that's what I thought. so it is 6 damage, but it is piercing. So it's probably not going through.
Is that from your plus one? Do you have a plus one rune on there?
I do, yes.
Okay, cool.
Describing what happens to Klaus now that the mechanics aren't bogged down. Yeah, so there's that moment of terror where of like Klaus feels constricted and is like, oh my Nethys, what am I gonna do? And just missed straight up as just like a reaction. And thankfully it works in his favor as he reforms and strikes out at this Stone Daddy in front of him. But yeah, that is one action. And I get 2 more. But I'll step back 1 square.
Mm-hmm.
Do I have society? I don't think I do. Could I argue academia based on the fact that it seems like this person's doing studying in this room? Maybe there's something that I looked at.
Actually, also, your hat seems to have provided that. 0 value.
Oh, well, the hat actually boosts my arcana. So if I need to roll that.
Oh, okay.
That might, no, you don't know anything.
So that's 1 action, 2 actions, and last action will be to cast shield.
Cool. Good call. At the end of the round, a couple gremlins roll up around the corner.
No, no.
They seem to be talking to each other, and they turn and look over and like, what the fuck? And we'll see you guys next week.
Oh. All right. In the middle of combat?